and sisters, our mothers and fathers. We want people to think good of you. I travel the world by the help of Allah to spread the word of Allah. I've been to many places. When I get a chance, I speak good things about Nigeria. Do you know that? I say nice things because it's my duty. I'm not a Nigerian, I'm a Zimbabwean. But when I travel, it's my duty, having interacted with you and mixed with you and seen you, it's my duty to let people know, guys, Nigerians are actually good people. If you don't know, I am letting you know. So my brothers and sisters, remember, whenever you want to change a narrative, you need interaction and you need communication and you need to be able to prove people wrong regarding the wrong that they know and to make it correct. So we are honest, we smile, we help others and so on. The same thing is happening to other nationalities as well. At times, they have a reputation that precedes them. But I want to tell you, you are not alone. You are not alone. But listen, my beloved brothers, my sisters, those who were better than you had a bigger problem than you. Those who were better than you were facing negative narratives in a worse way than you. So do not despair. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the greatest of creation, the most noble of all prophets of Allah, they said he's a madman. They said he is after women. Don't they say the same about Nigerian men? They say he's after money. Don't they say the same about others? They say he was after power. He power hungry. He just wants to rule here. That's it. Don't they say that about us sometimes? But all that was lies. There might be one or two people, a few people who might have those habits. What about the millions? Subhanallah. So who is better, you and I or Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? There is no doubt. It's not even a question. There is no comparison. He was much better, indeed. But I tell you what, in his case, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, don't worry about what they are saying. They don't know. They don't know anything. قَدْ نَعْلَمُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in a beautiful way, we know. What do we know? إِنَّهُ لَيَحْزُنُكَ الَّذِي يَقُولُونَ فَإِنَّهُمْ لَا يُكَذِّبُونَكَ وَلَكِنَّ الظَّالِمِينَ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ يَجْحَدُونَ. We know that it hurts you what they say about you, but we want you to know that they do not belie you. They know that you are truthful. They know the truth about you, but the wrongdoers, they just want to deny. They want to deny. Out of denial, they are saying these things. Allah has raised you above them, but they want to deny it. That's what Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was told. So many times, Allah told him, don't worry about what they are saying. You continue doing the work. If you could, if guidance was in your hands, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you would have guided them, but guidance is only in the hands of Allah. So, what happened? Over time, he proved them wrong. There are so many stories in the Sunnah, in the life of Muhammad, peace be upon him.
Peace be upon him. Allah.
That show how even those who thought he was bad, when they interacted with him, it corrected the narrative immediately. Many of them accepted Islam immediately. They saw, look at the day of the Fatih of Makkah, the victory of Makkah. The Prophet, peace be upon him, was coming into Makkah with a large army of Muslimin coming back to his place. And the people of Quraysh were standing in front looking, wondering what is he going to do. And he says, oh people of Quraysh, ماذا تظنون أني فاعل بكم. You know, You know what harm you've done, how many of us you have killed, how much harm you have done by stealing our property and driving us out of our own homes in Makkah. Now that we are coming back, what do you think we are going to do to you today? What do you think I am going to do to you today? They used to call him names. They used to call him so many bad things. But you know what? On that day, they knew he was a good man. They had to hope goodness. And you know what? They had to say, well, we hope that there will be some goodness. He says, اِذْهَبُوا فَأَنْتُمُ الطُّلَقَى. You can go. You are free. لَا تَثْرِيبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْيَوْمِ. No retribution against you today. Amazing. Many of them looked and they said, wow, such a great man, such a powerful man. It was easy for him to execute all of us, but he decided with his power to humble, to forgive, to be able to be clement of the highest degree or to the highest degree. And what happened? Automatically they entered the fold of Islam. And those who hated Islam, at least their enmity towards Islam was reduced. Now I come to the question. I started off by asking you about yourself, because you know that yes, people sometimes have a false narrative and we need to change it. But I ask you today, if you ask, Lord, what is Islam? What will they say? What is Islam? Not the Muslims. We're not asking Muslims. You go to the non-Muslims of the globe. Here in your own country, you ask them, what do you think Islam is? What will they tell you? They will probably say, it is a religion of killing, right? It is a religion of violence. What else will they say? They will say, it is a religion of quarrels. What else will they say? It is a religion of terrorism and extremism. It is a religion of hate. What else will they say? They will tell you so many things, but you know what? None of that is Islam. It is not Islam. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Allah says, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have only sent you as a mercy to al-alameen, to the worlds, to all that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen you to be sent to. All of it, we have sent you as a mercy. The one who was sent as a mercy and the religion is being looked at as a religion of barbarism, no, there is something wrong. My brothers and sisters, I want to tell you, Islam is one thing and the Muslims are another thing. I remember a prominent revert to Islam. He says, I thank Allah that I met Islam before I met the Muslims. Because if I met the Muslims, I would see people who hate each other, people who fight with each other, people who deceive each other, who despise each other, people who perhaps perpetrate acts of violence in the name of the faith. So if I met the Muslims first, I would be far away. But I met Islam first, and the teachings of Islam first, and the words of Allah first. So I turned to Allah. I turned to Allah. The power of the word of Allah is unmatched. Here is Umar ibn al-Khattab, an enemy of Islam prior to entering Islam. And you know what he says? He wants to go out to murder, to kill the messenger, peace be upon him, because he was fed up of what he heard. It was the wrong narrative. But Allah wanted that narrative to be reclaimed. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him set out, come out from his house. As he came out of the house, do you know what happened? Someone met him and told him, where are you going? You're looking so angry, etc. He says, I'm today going to sort out this man. The story is going to be finished. He says, why don't you start with your own sister? She's a Muslim. The idea was decoy, trying to avoid, trying to stop this man from doing the harm. When he went to his sister's house, cutting a long story short, he interacted with the Quran. He interacted with the Book of Allah. A few words only In a nutshell, he was taken to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Prophet, peace be upon him, through the mercy that Allah put in his heart, he made a dua, supplication, saying, "Oh Allah, guide to Islam one of these two enemies of Islam, either Abu Jahl or Umar ibn Khattab." Here comes Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, and he enters the fold of Islam. He enters the fold of Islam. What changed the narrative and changed the man forever? The word of Allah. Today I am standing in front of you. Why? Because of the word of Allah. Because we have been speaking about how to get closer to Allah. That's why you are here in your numbers. For me, it is historic. But for you, my brothers and sisters here in Port Harcourt in Nigeria, it is a historic moment. May Allah forgive our sins. May Allah bless you and your nation and grant us peace and stability that we desperately need in order to grow. Prove to the rest that we are not people who are violent. Clean your heart. Ala wa inna fil jasadi la mudghah. إِذَا صَلَحَتْ صَلَحَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ وَإِذَا فَسَدَتْ فَسَدَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ أَلَا وَهِيَ الْقَلْبُ. The Prophet, peace be upon him, says, "Behold, in the body there is an organ. If it is good and pure, the whole body will be good and pure. And if it is dirty and diseased, sick, then the whole body will be dirty, diseased and sick." That organ is the heart. So cleanse it. Remove from it hatred within the home to start with, in the community. And it's not a joke. It's not going to be easy to clean your heart, but clean your heart. It's not easy not to be jealous, but stop being jealous. Thank Allah for what you have. The Prophet, peace be upon him, says, "Look at what you have been bestowed with. Look at those who have been given less than you in order for you to appreciate what you have." The problem with us, we have a little mobile phone called the Nokia 6110, and we are busy looking at those who have the Samsung 10 Plus. Have you seen the latest Samsung 10 Plus? Have you seen it? It's only coming out next year, inshallah. But my brothers and sisters, we are already waiting. And we are sad. And we are jealous because someone is driving a better car than ours. Brother, you are already driving a car. What about those who are walking barefoot, kilometers on end, and they are still saying, "Subhanallah, Subhanallah, Subhanallah," as they are walking? Who is better? The one sitting in luxury without the Subhanallah, or the one who is walking step by step and thanking Allah, "Oh Allah, you have given me legs, I'm walking." Where is Islam and where are the Muslims? The narrative needs to be reclaimed. We are the people of Allah.